G'day guys, Matt here, and this is Farming Simulator 2013 on how to farm sugar beets and potatoes. This will be a combine of these two specific plants because these are new to the series, as well as I didn't really cover them too well in the actual harvesting and planting, or seeding and planting of the of this. I did all like wheat and the grass. Alright, so this tractor here is, well, nothing important, it's just a getting around tractor. But what I'll do is I'll order up what I want. And you see I got the money, this is my soil thing. So let's say about four of these units. Harmless mace, no. We need that. Trailers, we're not going to really worry about at this point in time. We do need a cultivator, but grab this one. Well, technically you don't need it, I just need it for quickly selling. Sewing machine, we need that one. And we need, say, sugar beets. Take two of those actually, and which one I just picked up? Plain potatoes. Oh, okay, sorry, I brought the wrong one. And this machine here. Alright, so we'll just warp them over here. I forgot to order the weights, but I can do that in a minute. It's like unpoised. Ground really shakes, as they all say. Right, just quickly going to get the weights. I'm just going to grab these ones. Alright, so let's do these one at a time, so we won't get you confusing. Alright, so basically with harvesting these two types, you need a specific harvester, not like the average one you usually use, such as like these ones here. You need these, you can A, go for the cheaper one, which is like something similar like this, or you can go for the expensive ones, which are the actual machine itself. With these cheaper ones, you do need a secondary trailer. No, not really a trailer, but you do need to do them manually. With the big machines, you can hire a worker. And where's the weights? No, there they are. Bastard. Alright, so we got one of these. Now I just want to quickly do something right now. I don't understand why, like a truck, fair enough, but attractive sounding like that. What has the world come to, my friend? Somehow I must have... Oh, I remember, because I was trying it out. Make sure I do it right for you guys. Alright. First things first is to plant these. Sometime today or twice. So not to confuse these, we're gonna put these two in different areas. Whoops. So this is the potato seeder. Now there's this big one here. Then I think I brought the smaller one as well. I thought I did. Potato. Oh, I think I was, and then I accidentally brought the big one as well. Actually, this part doesn't really matter which one I use. So why am I doing this? Honestly, I don't know what I'm doing. Oh, I do know what I'm doing, sorry. I just don't know why am I grabbing a small one. Alright, so is that feeling? We'll go take this one over. Now remember, these will have markers. Markers just tell you what's a good spot to do. You can get the computer or the AI to do this for you. Hire worker, whatever you want to call them. So make sure when you line them up like that. Make sure you get at least most of the way on there like this. When you set him up, make sure you put the marker you want him to go next. So we want him to go from the left towards the right, via the worker. Okay, I never saw him did that before. Gotcha. There we go. We'll check on him in a bit. Right, so we got this guy here. Wish the weight, you can put the weights on them more. already. Oh, I should have lined them up properly. Fuck's sake. These next ones will be easier now. Same thing with this one. This one has markers. And don't worry, the markers are doing that. They will get raised over. So we'll go and check on the other guy now, see if he's coming back. Apparently they tend to do this, depends which one they're using. So after they done this, just quickly go over and, you know, do the spots they missed. Alright, so let's move on with the next slot, which is the sugar beets. At least I'm doing the sugar beets now. And there's pretty much just this one that comes with it. Last time I missed one, just let me know. This one also does corn. Pea. We got that one. Oh yeah, apparently it's only that one. So you have to buy this one, so that's why I got two of them. That one refueling, I'll quickly get this one set up as well. See, we're slowly cleaning up the lot. A lot. And we'll use that other tractor to shift stuff over. Can I squeeze in and grab him? Thank you. Make sure you select the sugar beet icon on the left, right there. So we got these tractors set up properly. Make sure you set it up as previous did. And hire a worker. Now for this one I'm actually going to put this one here and do it so that these can speed up. So I'm not going to worry about being in our tractor. Alright, get this guy ready. Now I don't know if it really makes a difference with spraying them or using newer whatever. So I just tend to do it, just, you know, getting used to it. Get you starting filling up. As you're filling up, I'll quickly move these other machines out of the way. No. Which one are you? I think you're the sugar bean, and I think you're... I think I got it wrong. I'm gonna double check. I did get it wrong. As you see, the front end is a little different. I was inside the building then. Yeah, see, the front ends are different. This is the potato one. I like the sound of run, 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 run. Whoa! I know you're big and all that, but that doesn't mean you can do four-wheel driving. Yeah, see, the farm is in the bush, mate. You need to do four-wheel driving everywhere, mate. Alright, actually I'll leave those there. Alright, I'm gonna be back after these guys are planted and hose them down with the sprayer and all that. Actually, yeah, basically that's pretty much it with the seeding side. So I'll wait till these grow up and I'll show you the harvesting side. Welcome back, guys. Some new stuff. There's a patch have been, or update that was a few days ago or so, where this used to be yellow and orange, now it's light blue, mid blue to dark blue. One thing they should really fix is the grass part. So I have a different color scheme for the grass, because, you know, how are you supposed to tell the normal the other ways of like wheat, barley, canola and such is ready. So the not the potatoes, the sugar beets are ready. Potatoes are still coming along. So I'm going to do the sugar beets now and then I'm going to speed up the thing again to get the potatoes ready. Alright, so basically with the more cheaper version, as the way it looks like, or the one where you don't use the big giant machine over there. Use these two little things over here. First you need to use this. Now I want to point out these you have to do these manually. There's no hire the worker option. So you have to put up this. So my recommendation is to actually buy the big machine so you can do it all with workers. But that's only if you're interested in it. Come on, I don't really have time for this. Oh, if it doesn't work, it doesn't work. Alright, so basically turn this on. Lower it. Push 1. I think 2 doesn't really work. And start cutting away. So this gets rid of the top parts. And like I said, you got to do this bomb manually. So I'm only going to do about 2 rows of this stuff. So the potatoes are just ready up. Excuse for the stupid way of doing it, but meh. And after that, you so after you do all that, you jump into this one over here. This one looks like a sort of like a cage match. Sugar beet cage match! Alright, so you gotta unfold it. Which the thing is, all it does, it just rotates to one side. Steam is, if you just saw that notification, Steam has actually took away the slash me, which is like a, your writing does go into a different colour, besides white or grey, goes into blue or green, depends what you're doing. Alright, so what we'll do here is, lower it, turn it on. Go 1 speed. And now you are picking up these sugar beads. And you notice the white bits are gone now after I drive over it. So this is the cheap way of somewhat doing it. If you don't want to do this manual, I recommend you to get the more expensive ones, like I keep saying. This is a little stupid. So like pretty much 2 rows of this area does fill it up quite quickly. Now get out of my way. Get out of my way. Oh, look at that. The pipe's gone out. And yeah, it just goes into there. I don't know if you can really see it. Yeah. Clicks back over. Actually, I gotta move that now. So that's pretty much the cheap way, really. mark in bold. One thing I have complained about this is the hog goes too low. And so this harvester does both of them, and it does it all by itself. And for a machine it does, that bites by itself, it costs about
that much, almost 5,000.
500,000. So it's more work. Well, put it this way, it's like you're only doing this just for the game. It doesn't really make that much of a profit unless it's on demand. Now you can put this stuff away in storage or whatnot. But really up to you. Now it's just no point of doing anything. You should not get full that fast if it stops. Looks like it's going away.
The only one thing I wish the guys do is get rid of those bloody trees near the fields. That's the only one thing I like that patch to do.
At least have a chainsaw or some sort to get rid of them. You know, I don't mind paying like 5 grand for a chainsaw. When you use it, you chop down the tree and then you go use fuel and someone. You pay money to get rid of the tree. I'd rather do that than just have bloody trees there. So that's going to take a while to get full. And this would have been a good time to do the potato side of stuff. But apparently it's still not ready. I don't really want to speed up the time because trying to do these tutorials during the day's time. Like I said, if the sugar beets die now, it's not really important anymore because I showed you how it's done. Speed up time a bit. Oh, is it ready? Oh no. Oh well, it was a bit taller. Yeah, that's right, just push me in. See, this little tractor's not that powerful, even with the light trailer.
If you wonder how you get your sugar beets,
go around the back here and so also for potatoes, you go around the back and you go under the chute. And I actually buzzed the animation. Same for the potato one. Yeah, don't go right under it, you just go near it. Apparently it's working now. Now I can show you guys the potato side. Is it fully done? Yeah, it's close enough. Put that down medium. Oh. Alright, so now the potato side. Alright, for this one, you don't really need the weight, because I'm pretty sure you can do this with the front and back side. You don't need this weight. Just make sure you go the way where the wheels are facing. That like this, facing away. Right, so we need to put that down, turn it on, push G, unfold the harvester part. And turn that on. Let's see what happens. Right. As you can see here, the harvester is more to the right than the actual tractor itself. So apparently you have to do this too, but you might not be able to do that. And excuse me, not for driving it and doing it properly. I just don't really see the point of doing it properly. I'm just pretty much showing you the cheap way. Now, park out. You know, you see the little traction there? I jump out. That there, because that how the potatoes get picked up. Well, that's pretty much easy. Yeah, you're supposed to line it up more properly. That's how you do the potatoes, the cheapy way. make some cheap chips. Oh yeah, so that's what I've got to do. I've got to lift it up. Silly me. Anyway, let's do it the other way so we can finish this video off. I just had it in too. God damn it. And once again, this is the reason why I hate having so many vehicles. Yeah. Like I said, it does both things as well as hired worker. And yeah, so we'll go back to the other one. But I'll use this tractor. And that's pretty much it with that. There you go. Like I said, it's better to do them with the big vehicles as well as doing them on big fields and then store them away to a demand. That's the best advice I can give you guys, is to store it away to a demand. Hello mate, just giving you a bit of a nudge. Come on, I want some chips, mate. So I'm going to end it here because it's pretty much simple after this. You just put them away and wait till the mine comes. And there's pretty much nothing else I can really teach you guys. So hopefully this will help you guys out. Sorry it's a bit long, but it's, at least it's easier to understand. Please like if this helps. Favorite. As well as comment telling I did a good job on it. A good job on it, and watch my other tutorial videos, as well as let me know if you want to see more farming simulator videos. If not, I'll be doing one last episode and calling it quits by moving on to Far Cry 3. Like I said, please like, comment and subscribe, and thanks for watching.